I've always hung out with long hairs. I've always hung out with people of that ilk. I'm one of the original. I had sideburns down to my chin in 55. For a while there, I did.
Yeah.
When I started my own TV show in Nashville in 69, I had a group called The Who on as guests. And I forget which one of them said, thank God we got somebody on television with long hair, talking about me, you know? Although it wasn't all that long.
Right. Do you really need to tour so much? Do you need to work so hard and drive yourself so hard?
For my soul, I do. Yeah, for my soul. It's a gift. My mother always told me that any talent is a gift of God, and I always believed it. If I quit, I would just live in front of the television and get fat and die pretty soon. So I don't want to do that. You know, I just hope and pray I can die with my boots on. I've been in hospital beds, and I don't want to end it up there. I went through a period that I didn't want to sing those old songs again. I finally decided that I was really cheating them and myself, and I started singing all the old ones with gusto and lust, like I loved them. Those songs, I Walk the Line, Folsom, Sunday Morning Coming Down, Ring of Fire, they're part of me. They're an extension of me. When I get in front of that microphone, here's part of me going through that mic, you know, to that audience. And they feel it, and they know it if I feel it. And they'll turn it right back to me, the appreciation. That's what it's all about. That's what performing is all about, is sharing and communicating.
Judy, could you ever have been a preacher? Were you ever tempted to?
No.
No.
I think in my world of religion, you're called to preach or you don't preach, you know, called by God to preach. I've never been ordained by God to preach the gospel. If I have a calling, it's called to perform and sing. I think gospel song is a ministry in a way, you know. Gospel music is so ingrained into my bones, you know. I can't do a concert without singing a gospel song. It's what I was raised on. It was a thing that inspired me as a child, growing up on a cotton farm where the work was drudgery. And it was so hard that when I was in the field, I sang all the time, and usually gospel songs, because they lifted me up above that black dirt.
I've got a home in glory land that outshines the sun way beyond the blue.
I was going to ask you how the pain is in your jaw these days.
It's pretty severe.
Really? Yeah. All the time, constant?
Almost all the time, yeah. Except when I'm on stage.
Really?
Yeah.
That's miraculous that it just leaves you.
Yeah.
The power of music, I guess.
Yeah, I pray for that, and it works. It doesn't alter or hinder my performance.
It must be a struggle to have to take painkillers at the same time to be able to
regulate them. I can't take them. It's like an alcoholic, you know. He can't drink, and
sure.
I can't take pain pills.
You must be very brave to, you know.
No, I'm not very brave, because for 5 years I didn't try to take the pain. I fought it. I had a total of 34 surgical procedures on my left jaw.
Yeah.
Every doctor I've been to knows what to do next, too.
Guys, I'm doing my project on politics and genre of music. Thank you.
Hey, I'm Christy James, and I just want to talk about quickly something that I like to call the genre war. You know, I think being a country music artist, we get a lot of that stigma attached to that particular genre. And when I go to write my music and release my music, it's always, that's not really country enough, or that's more rock, or that's too country to sit in this genre or that genre. And my personal views on the matter are that I think it's governed by people that are used to hearing a certain style of music and putting a label on that. And I think that we shouldn't put labels on music. I don't really like genres. When I write a song. I write something that I love, and I don't care what genre it may or may not sit in. What is important is that the music is being heard, and it's being delivered to people that enjoy what they hear. So the genre war is a hard one to win, I think, in any industry, because you have radio stations that, you know, play particular genres only, and they won't open it up beyond that because their listener is not willing to or doesn't want to hear something that they aren't used to hearing. So I guess it really all comes down to learned behavior, and people are very protective of what they believe a genre should or shouldn't be, or what music should or shouldn't be within that particular genre. So yeah, I don't know how it's ever going to change while everybody decides where they believe a particular piece of music should or shouldn't sit. But from my particular viewpoint, I will just write music and not put a label on it, because at the end of the day, I think it's all music.
And as Chrissy pointed out, there is a genre war. People are constantly bickering about what genre music is. And also, I agree, who has the biggest money is an influence of this.